and welcome to Darvanalee Designs Studio. My name's Nicole Reed, and thank you very much for choosing to join us for 2019 Foundation Paper Piecing Block of the Month. Now, this is a free block of the month, so you don't have to pay for any of the patterns or anything like that. And you will be able to find them all over, all linked up down below, which will take you over to our blog that has a downloadable pattern. Now, if you have any problems, I am contactable via email or through our Facebook group. The Facebook group is linked up down below, along with our email address as well. It's a nice, simple one. It is askme.dds@gmail.com. So you can shoot me an email over there and I can answer any of the questions that you want. Now, some of the questions that I have already received is, where will I find each block? Well, I have a dedicated playlist to it, just like I did for 2018, and it will have 2019 Foundation Paper Piecing Block of the Month will be the title of it. So you will be able to find it there. Also, you might be wondering what you're going to need for this Block of the Month series. Well, I decided at the end of last year that I wasn't going to ask any of you to go out and buy any extra tools or anything like that. Basically, we are going to use the tools that we have available already in our quilting and sewing arsenal. So what I will suggest you do is, if you are only ever using 100% cotton thread for your machine, you will need to purchase some polyester. I recommend that, especially if you're new to foundation paper piecing, because polyester thread is a little bit stronger. Now, depending on what colors that you use for your fabrics, you will then have to decide what cotton you're going, polyester thread you're going to use. So I recommend that you have a light gray, a dark gray, a black, a cream, and a white, and that way you will be able to cover any color that you choose. Now, if you've got multicolor, just use the light gray. It blends with most fabrics. Some other things that you're going to need is, you're going to need a rotary cutter. I personally use a 28 millimeter one, but a 45 millimeter one is absolutely perfect. You'll need to put a new blade in it, okay, and you will need to have a spare blade for the year, because we will be trimming up our fabrics, and there is a lot of trimming that happens with foundation paper piecing. So get yourself a new blade, get your rotary cutter, and set that up for yourself. You're also going to need some sewing machine needles, and I recommend that you use top stitching needles. That way they've got a nice sharp point and they go through the paper quite well. You're going to need, and hopefully not ever use, a quick pick. I recommend that you have this beside your sewing machine, because inevitably you will make some sort of mistake at some stage. I do it, everybody does it. So have a good sharp quick pick. And the reason I'm saying that you need it to be sharp is because we are working with smaller stitches, and you know that if you've got a blunt quick pick, it can make the job a little bit harder. You are going to need a glue stick or a glue pen. So this is my glue pen. I get these off eBay. They're just a little blue glue pen, and you will see me use that throughout the series. But you can use an acid-free glue stick, the ones that you get for kids to take to school. You can use that, and we only use a little bit of it, so you'll be right. But just make sure it is acid-free. You're going to need a sharp pair of paper scissors. We don't want to be using our fabric scissors, so you want a good sharp pair of paper scissors, and you should have some in your kit already. This is a specialty item that I use, and I used to just use my fingernail or the edge of my ruler, but some sort of hand presser. There are rollers out there, there are these little ones. You could even use a scrapbooking boner, I think they're called, or creaser, that will work as well. But that'll just save you getting up and down to the iron. And if you're like me, I don't actually have my iron near my sewing machine, so I do have to get up to it. So I use this for foundation paper piecing, but you can just use the edge of your ruler or you can use your thumbnail. It's just to make sure that those seams are open. Okay, so something along those lines would be good. And you're also going to need, which seems like a very strange thing, there are rulers out there called add a quarter and stuff like that. So I'll put a link down below. If you want to purchase one of those, you can hit that link down below, but it's not necessary. Okay, just a piece of template plastic or a postcard or a thin piece of cardboard. So you can see like cereal box cardboard is perfect for it. You want it to have a nice straight edge. Okay, so this is my piece and you can see I've run over it a couple of times, but this is what I use for all my foundation paper pieces. I have been doing it for quite some time and I have never gone out and purchased any specialty tools or the add a quarter or anything like that. I basically use this little ruler, which you can see there, and I'll just put my hand behind it. You can see there that it actually has clear quarter inch markings, so it's a nice solid line. Okay, and I use this, and I'll show you in the videos what I do with those. All right, so the next thing you want to know is how much fabric you need. Okay, so you can see here that these are the fabrics that I've got. We want high contrasting. So my background fabric is going to be white, and you'll need 3.5 meters of that. And then the black is going to be acting as my dark fabric, and you're going to actually need 2 meters of that. And the red is playing as my light fabric in this quilt, and you'll need 1.5 meters of that. And this one here is my binding fabric, and you'll need about 80 centimeters of that. So I will actually work out what all the equations are for it in yards, but even if you just got 3.5 yards, 2 yards, and a yard and a half of those, and about 3/4 of a yard for your binding, you should be okay. You, as I said, you will have some left over, so you'll be able to make some little projects with that. Now, you might be wondering, the black, how do I know whether it's playing as a light and a dark? Well, my easy suggestion for that is basically just hold them together like how I am here. Even though these are actually dark colors, you can see that the red is actually playing as a light fabric, and my black is playing as the dark. So that's what you want to look at. You want some high contrasting colors. Okay, they can be patterned if you want. That's entirely up to you, but if you've never done this before, may I suggest just get home spun, because if you forget to have a fabric facing up or right sides together, and you won't have to unpick, because you can't tell the difference between the two. Okay, so that's the fabric side of things that you'll need. And of course, you'll need to join me here every month. The second Wednesday of every month is when our block of the month will go up, right through to December. So I really do hope that you'll join us for this foundation paper piecing series. It is geared towards beginners, so but it doesn't mean that advanced people can't join in the fun as well. So if you're new to my channel, hit that subscribe button and the little bell icon beside it, and that way you won't miss out on any of the uploads for the block of the month. And as I said, you will always find them in a playlist, and it is 2019 block of the month foundation paper piecing. So make sure that you subscribe to that, and that way to the channel, and that way you won't miss out on any of the blocks. If you have want to share your pictures and everything like that with us, by all means, click the link down below to our Facebook group, and one of the moderators or myself will add you to the group, and then you can share all your creations from the channel and other things with us over in that group. It's a very active group. We've got a lot of people that chit chat and all that sort of stuff. So I'm looking forward to working with you and teaching you how to do foundation paper piecing this year for 2019. And I really hope to see some of your comments below our videos. If you like this video today, give us a thumbs up down below. And if you're new here, hit that subscribe button and the little bell icon beside it, and that way you won't miss out on any future posts. For those that don't know, my name's Nicole Reed for Darvanalee Design Studio, and I'll see you next week for the first block. Bye for now.